Good morning or afternoon or evening, depending on where you are. I'm Hammer Abby, and I'm here with Rippy Longstocking and our producer, Nura. You are watching the Birthday Bash live from State College, Pennsylvania, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Roller Derby Association Broadcasting. That's us. This morning, we're going to see Dutchland Derby Rollers taking on Rock City Roller Derby. Dutchland hails from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. They're coming to this tournament as part of the B bracket. It's an A bracket and B bracket this weekend. And Rock hails from Rochester, New York, where they are also part of the B bracket this weekend. We're going to go over the team rosters for you before we get into some other details about how you can further enjoy your tournament experience this weekend with us, because it is a two-day tournament. There's going to be a lot of roller derby this weekend for you to tune in for. I'm going to start off with Dutchland Roller Derby before I throw it over to Rippy. So Dutchland today is bringing number 108, Solar Flexus, 11, Pandemonium, 124, Min Diesel, 13 is Repercussions, 15, Bangarang Banshee, 17, Chronic Youth, 1793, Marie Antoinette, 24, Tempe of Doom, 28, Terror Swift, 282 is Dash Ketchum, 3864 is Astro Thunder Thighs, and 411, Lorraine Storm, 518, Acid Rain, 6 is Steel Wool, 73 is Max Casualties, 912 is Princess Peach. They will be coached by Cape Mayhem, Scarlet Syntax Terror, and Kelsey Stevenson. So Rippy, who's playing for Rock today?
All right, the Rock City Roller Derby roster goes like this. Zero, I believe that is a six. Or an 8, 4, 7, sorry, Ziggy Scarguts, 10, Miranda Ndahi, 13, Kiara Teed, 138, Cyberpunk, 1792, Harlot Pimpernel, 200, Storm Damage, 2150, Fifi, 24, Cam, 27, Hater Tot, 280, Twisted Teed, 4, Stress Flasher, 42, Meals on Wheels, 443, Bruise and Daisy, 481, Ashley Garak. P-Rex is number 5, 51 is Grim, 711, Slamber Alert, and 934 is Post Mortimer. Coached today by Fail Exception, Damian Camacho, and Cashman. Let's talk about who's going to be on the track officiating for us today. The skaters will be Freddie Mercury Poisoning, Scruff Canuck, Dread Patchouli, Corporal Chaos, Damon Mistress. Is it Damon Mistress or Demon Mistress? Do you know that, Hammer?
I think you'd go Demon, technically.
Okay.
Even with the spelling, I think.
Yes. Guinness, Smiley, and Bacon Ater. Do you want to tell us about NSOs?
I'd be happy to. Love some NSOs. Today we've got Quick Grayson, Captain Crunchberry, or Cap'n Crunchberry, I should say. Quick Grayson again. Oh, it's on there twice. Fun. Veronica Scars, Cupcake. No Hammond, No Fowlin', Strong Female Protagonist, Bloodless, Bionic Bitch, and Kermit the Grog.
Big shout out to all of our officials out there. We can't do it without them. If you are new to Derby, check us out at www.wftda.com and learn the rules of the game and more. Got questions for us? We're also on Twitter, and you can find us using the handle at WFTDALive. So the L in that is capitalized, and the hashtag talk to the number 2 WFTDA. You can ask questions during the show, and we'll try to answer some of your questions in the chat throughout the game. And so make sure you talk to us, because we will call you out and try to answer questions.
Well, I mean, you know, talk to us in a respectful manner, because otherwise we will call you out.
Correct. Very true.
You know, we're all volunteers here, so just be kind. It's early in the morning. Although I do see we have at least one person in the Twitch chat who is here from Australia, so shout out to you being up very late at night, as I understand. So we're getting close to go time here. I'm excited. I'll be honest with our viewers. This is my first time doing one of these virtual remote announcing gigs. After what I think is a long and storied career as an announcer in person, this is a fun new challenge. I'm glad we're doing this, and it's wonderful to be with all of you this morning.
Mm-hmm. Right, so we've got just seconds away. Sorry, go ahead.
And you will notice there is a time delay in our mics, but we are going to work it out as we get going. And I have more caffeine in my body this morning. So that rolling whistle means it is time to start this game. Two 30-minute halves if you're new to roller derby. And we've got an awesome camera op who's going to help us see the whole track, which I super appreciate. And we'll tell you who the jammers are once we can see names and numbers. It looks like it'll be Solar Flexus for Dutchland going up against Fifi for Rock City. Rock City in white, Dutchland in black this morning. Rock with the first lead jammer call of the game. Nice little duck and weave on the outside line. Going to get Fifi through on her first scoring pass of the game. That's going to be 4 points on the board. Solar Flex is still stuck behind Rock City's blockers close to the jam line. Get recycled back as Fifi comes around for a second scoring pass. Knocked to the outside, though. Fifi is going to have to come back and re-enter. Does so without too much trouble. Gets through for another 4 points. The whole pack is now moved into turn two, and I can't tell if that was a full star pass. Looks like it might have been. I don't see a pivot on the track anymore. But Fifi's going to go ahead and call that off before any return fire can happen. So Rock's going to end that first jam with a big 12 points on the board.
Yeah, it does look like, Hammer, that was successful right before the call off there. So if you're recording this, it would be an official star pass. Got lots of loves happening in the chat. Shout out to Bloodless. Shout out to Freddie Mercury Poisoning. As we head into jam number two of our first game this weekend, Twisted Teen is wearing the star for Rock City. Looks like Steel Wool on the line for Dutchland. It is Rock City out again for lead. Twisted Teed coming into the pack. Looks like Steel Wool out of the pack. Eligible for scoring, but that will be called. 4 points on the board for Rock City. Brings them to 16-0. We're counting down 27 and 40 or so. 27 minutes, 40 seconds left in the half.
Nothing like some roller derby to start your Saturday morning. Although it's 10 o'clock where they are, we're playing in State College, Pennsylvania today. A little later than where I am in the Central Time. I have played derby games at 8 in the morning, though, so I just have a lot of sympathy for this early morning play. It's a challenge. So we've got Max Casualties on the line for Dutchland. In the black, that's going to be Street Flasher. Naughty. For Rock City in the white. And it's going to be Rock with lead again. Third lead in a row for Rock. Nice little spree for them this morning so far. Street Flasher getting hit to the outside. Looks like pulling a penalty and headed to the penalty box for 30 seconds. So Rock and Street Flasher now with a power jam opportunity. Dutchland hitting the jammer out. Looks like, however, they're able to come back in safely. Nice cue from their teammates, like, you're good, you're good. So Street Flasher coming around into turn two. The pack starts to move into the far straightaway, gaining a little bit of speed, trying to slow Street Flasher down, unsuccessful. Around the outside and through for another 4 points. So this is going to bring Rock's total to 8 on this jam. As Max Casualties back out of the penalty box joins the fray on the far straightaway, trying to push through those formidable Rock blockers. And really want to sing that to the tune of Rock Lobster. Not going to do it. Too early. And there's the call off. It was a little too casual for the refs right away there, but it's going to be 12 points on the jam for Rock. Dutchland still scoreless as we head into jam four.
If you're still not quite awake yet and you want to watch this game later, all of our games are published on YouTube a few days after the event. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you hit that thumbs up button to let us know you like the show. It really does help us out. Heading into jam number four, Min Diesel taking on Cyberpunk off the jammer line. Fletchland looking for that lead jammer status, the first lead for them this game. But nope, Rock will take it this time again. Cyberpunk out as lead jammer. Min Diesel gets bumped right out there right before turn one. But Cyberpunk through the pack again, puts up 4 points. And that will be called at the 4 points. That brings Rock City to 32.
Rock City definitely off to a strong start here this morning, Rippy, with a 32-point lead after four jams. Dutchland zero, they're really going to have to put on the jets here and try to get some lead calls for their jammers, start putting some points on the board if they want to slow down this train. Princess Peach jamming for Dutchland. Fifi again for Rock City. Fifi is 3-4 lead for Rocks. They're going to go ahead and continue that streak. But hey, Princess Peach not too far behind by half a track. Gets out and is going to give chase. Pack waiting just before turn one. And Fifi's going to get through real quick. Grabs those points, calls it off, keeping Dutchland scoreless. 4-0 on that jam brings Rock City to a total of 36 to Dutchland 0. And Fifi, I think we're seeing, what did I just say, Fifi? Rippy. We're just seeing, it's too early. Rippy, we're seeing about a three or four, you know, one of the, sorry, I just caught myself just in time. 3 or 4 jam rotations so far from the teams. Get there.
That's all right. I answer to a mini name. We are looking at Still Wool, able to pick up lead for Dutchland. That is the first lead for Dutchland in this half. Twisted Tweed also out of the pack, eligible for points. So Dutchland looking to put the first points on the board. And it was, there's a call off. See, we got the full four here. Cannot read fingers through the screen, but we'll see. 4 points. So there's Dutchland picking up the 4 points. Brings us 36-4. 22 and a half minutes left in the first half.
All right. That's just what Dutchland needed to switch their momentum a little bit more into their favor here. We head into jam seven. And it's going to be max casualties for Dutchland against Kiara Teed. Kiara Teed for Rock City. A multiplayer call being assessed to the pivot from Dutchland. Jammer is still stuck, and I eat my words. That's going to be lead going to Rock City's Kiara Teed. Just as you start to say a thing, everything changes on the track. Max Casualty still stuck behind three rock blockers, headed into turn two, is able to spread the pack out a bit. Gonna get that no pack call and get through, just as Kiara Teed scores 4 points for Rock City. Pack hanging out in turn two, waiting for them to come around, but Rock's gonna call that off. They don't want any more points for Dutchland on that one. Lots of fours on the board right now. 4-0 in the jam in favor of Rock City. Rock City also up 42-4.
And a multiple of four. We're heading into jam eight.
Oh. It's too much math for this early in the morning.
It is. Shout out to Street Flasher on the Twitch. That Street Flasher from Blue Ridge Roller Derby. We have Min Diesel taking on Fifi on the jammer line. And it looks like Rock will continue that streak of leads. It's the one for Dutchland so far. Bunch of hits right there inside the pack. Wow! Fifi able to just duck on the outside lane. Swing through for 4 points. The pack is held up at the apex. Oh, almost. Oh, we do have a star pass, and that's Acid Rain now with the star for Dutchland. Fifi tried to make the apex leap, didn't quite land it, had to recycle back, but is now through the pack for 4 additional points. Oh, through the pack. Wow. Fifi just making it look a little easier than it actually is. 12 points so far for Fifi and Rock City. Acid Rain is out of the pack now, wearing the star. 16 points for Fifi. Looking at the bench to see if we're going to continue this jam so far. The bench says yes. And there's the call off. Not sure if Dutchland picked up any points on that pass. We'll see. Yes, 4 points for Dutchland. 17 points for Rock City on that run. Fifi, I think. Nura, I think that's the highest jam so far, yeah?
That's correct. 17 awesome. Points for Rock.
All the more impressive these days since we got rid of the jammer lap points. You're only scoring 4 points instead of yeah. 5 on a pass. So getting those high-scoring jams. A little notch in the belt for a jammer. So we've got Street Flasher jamming for Rock City and getting lead pretty quickly off the line there as Dutchland's jammer gets recycled back behind the start line. That's Solar Flexus. Street Flasher, apparently, according to the user on Twitch, this is Street Flasher's first game, which is fantastic. Doing just nice. Fine. This is the thing, like, you know, before when I was announcing pre-Panini, I had some history and context for the players, but I'm just, it's like getting to know everybody all new again. Lots of new players coming up through the ranks, some old familiar faces. It's a good time. Good to be back. So Street Flasher are going to get through for, yes, 4 points for Rock City. And Solar Flex is still stuck in the pack, getting recycled back to turn 1. We are getting a penalty. It looks like a forearm call on Street Flasher. We'll send her to the box. I said too many nice things. It's the announcer curse. Headed to the penalty box. So now Solar Flex is out there with no other jammer to face off again. But Rock Blocker is going to make this difficult. Oh, nope. It has been a star pass now to the pivot. So Lorraine Storm will take the star for Dutchland and get through on the far straightaway. Opportunity for Dutchland to put some points on the board now, as this power jam will likely come to its conclusion soon here. Got a minute. Big pile up in turn 2. Rock recycling the jammer back close to turn 1. Rainstorm back in. Keep your Rex in the blocking pack there, doing a great job. Holding back Dutchland. We've got a dog with some opinions about roller derby. Happens with virtual. We're all used to it by now. It's nice to hear. So that jam will come to its conclusion. Rock with 7 in that jam to Dutchland, getting 2 points, squeaking them in there, bringing the total to 64-10. Rock with a still pretty commanding lead, as we have still 16 and a half minutes in the first half of gameplay.
It is pretty exciting. That, I believe, was the first jammer penalty. So that's good that both teams are kind of keeping that in check. We have Steel Wool taking on Twisted Tweed off the jammer line. And Rock picks up the lead again. That's Twisted Tweed out of the pack. But Steel Wool also finds an inside lane, is out of the pack, and eligible for points. This is a tweet through the pack, picks up 4, calls it, but I think, not sure if Dutchland was able to, yes, Dutchland was able to pick up 2 to Rock City's 4 on that pass. That brings a 68-12.
Yeah, it ain't over until it's over, Rippy. As a jammer, you got to push and try to, you know, turn your hips, get through for any last minute points you possibly can before the final whistle calls. All right. Got max casualties on the line again for Dutchland. Cyberpunk for Rock City. Oh, Big pile up on the near straightaway here. A couple of rock blockers going down. There's a whistle call though, going on the jammer from Dutchland. Oh no, Max Casualty's headed to the box.
Oh, no.
Didn't quite catch what the penalty was for. It just came after that pile up. So now a power jam for Cyberpunk, who's still stuck behind the pack going into turn one. Getting that pack moving. Cyberpunk takes advantage, finds an inside line, is through with lead. Rock has had lead, I believe, for all but one jam so far this half. Nero, back me up if you noticed that. I got that right. All right, Max Catchty's back on the track, takes a big hit in the far straightaway, but gets right back up again. Rock City Blocker's doing a nice job of holding her back and recycle her back into turn two. Cyberpunk also engaging with the pack in the far straightaway. Cyberpunk headed to the middle of the track for, I don't know, just a little reset, looks like. Back on the track now. Hopefully all is well. Star pass by Dutchland to the pivot. I will say, Dutchland making really good use of those star passes, using them quite frequently. Mm-hmm. That's kind of what you got to do if you're not getting lead. Stop the bleeding, get someone out. And they've got their good heads-up work on the star passes. Rock calling it off, though, or the jam coming to its end. I didn't quite catch it, I will admit. 4-0 on that one. 72-12 overall in favor of Rock City.
Talk about announcer's curse. I talked about how great it was that they didn't have any jammer penalties. Then straight to a jammer penalty. I would like to shout out, it looks like, to Littlefoot is the track repair person there in the little unicorn onesie. So I want to give a shout out to all of our volunteers who are helping us out today. That's Min Diesel on the line, taking on Kiara Teed. I believe Rock's going to hang on to that lead streak. Min Diesel at the front of the pack, trying to go up against this tripod. Rock City's defense doing a great job of hanging on to the jammers. But on the inside lane, Min Diesel makes it through. Kiara Teed through the pack, picks up the four. And gets the signal from the bench to call it off, which will happen. 4-0 on that run. That brings us 76-12 in favor of Rock City. We're about 12 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first half.
Man, they must be tearing up that trap because they are putting Littlefoot to work. All right, we do have a timeout being called by Dutchland. So we're going to have a little minute to recombobulate, talk about what we've seen so far. Rippy, Nira, how's this looking to you? What are you noticing?
Yeah, so it looks like Dutchland has had one lead so far and four star passes. So they're really utilizing the star pass, and they're doing a good job of that. But Rock is just getting all lead jammers, and they've only had one jammer penalty as well, so that helps.
Yeah.
We've had, looks like, two jammer penalties on the Dutchland side so far.
I'd say pretty clean jammers this morning, though. As someone who made a career as a jammer for a while, I always got a shout out. Especially, you know, it's a, you know, first thing in the morning, we're all getting the dust off from a long break of roller derby.
Yes.
Playing a tournament. This might be, sounds like it's some people's first game. So good, clean, I would say good, clean gameplay overall, not seeing a ton of blocker penalties either. So hopefully everybody's just having a good time out there.
Absolutely.
We get to play roller derby. Yay.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, speaking of having a good time and taking care of yourself, this is my transition. WFTDI Wellness is excited to team up with the Phoenix Project to provide an invaluable wellness resource to the community. Together, we are creating a vibrant community for healing, connection, and support in roller derby, and you can learn more at WFTDI.com. Oh, we're back. Jam 13. Dutchland has Solar Flexus out there. Fifi for Rock City. Rock with the lead on this jam. Continuing their streak. Oh, nice. Fifi sort of tiptoes behind a blocker on the first apex to get through. So up to 8 points. Got two walls, well, I should say tripods of blockers in that first turn, first and second turn right now. Doing a good job of holding up Solar Flexus, who is looking to do the star pass, hands it off to the pivot, but the pivot does get hit out of bounds, so they're going to have to reset to get through now. Fifi, meanwhile, rolling around another scoring pass, gets through with a little bit of opposition, not too much. Going to bring the total up to 16, see if Fifi can break the record for highest scoring jam so far in this game. I think that's it. Yep, so that's another 4 point pass. So we're going to bring it up to a 20-point jam for Rock City so far. Pivot is now out. That's Lorraine Storm now jamming for Dutchland. As Fifi comes around, hits a very tight pack in the far straightaway, calls it off before Lorraine Storm can get around for any more points. I don't know if Fifi picked up any last-minute points there. That might just be... I mean, that might just be 20-point jam. No big deal. Forgive me.
Nura, is that now the highest? Are we at a tie for the highest, or is that the highest jam?
That is the highest, and actually, Fifi is the one that has scored both of the highest jams so far for Rock.
Wow. Fifi doing some excellent work out there offensively. As we head into jam 14, we have Steel Wool taking on Twisted Teed. Both jammers finding some formidable defense out there. Looks only two blockers out there for Rock City, but oh, now three. We're coming back now. Okay, here we go. Everybody's back. Twisted Teed out of the pack for Rock City, all the way back around. Looks for the middle lane, gets denied. Now is out. Steel Wool also out, so they're going to call that one with 4 points on the board for Rock City. That brings them to an even 100. 100 to 12. Just over 9 minutes left in the first half.
So breaking the century mark in the first half, Rock City having a very good morning at the birthday bash. Remember, this is a two-day tournament, so we've got so much more roller derby coming up for you to tune in. Thank you for those of you who are watching with us this morning. Rock City going to send a Street Flasher back out to the line. Dutchland with Solar Flexus again. Oh, there it is. Dutchland with the lead. Solar Flexus pulling it out, finding an outside line open. As Street Flasher still stuck behind Dutchland's defense heading into turn one. He's going to get knocked to the inside. There are some penalties being called on blockers. I think Rock had lost one, who's now back on the track, but Dutchland just lost one as well. Solar Flexus already with 4 points on the board for Dutchland, coming around for another scoring pass. For a little bit of friendly fire there on turn one, it happens. Street Flasher now out of the pack and able to score. Dutchland decides to call it off after 8 points. A nice round 20 total for them to Rock City's 100. The streak is broken. Okay, are we starting with a power jam? Did I miss something? Fifi.
I think we're getting an official timeout here to settle some things and stuff. We'll see what comes
with
it, what
happens.
Shakes out here. Well,
I'm just going to.
Did you know?
Again, sorry. Go ahead. I'm really enjoying the dinosaur onesie. So, please continue.
Yes. Did I say you? Yeah. So this event is part of WFTDA's 2022 Back on Track Global Event Series, a celebration of the reemergence of our sport by showcasing roller derby events of all kinds happening around the world for the rest of the year. You can see the list of events at WFTDA.com/backontrack. So have you guys been watching any of the Back on Track events?
I have watched a little bit here and there. Yep. I haven't gotten to watch as much as I'd like, but it's been fun to see. Neera, what about you?
Yeah, I watched a lot of the CDG tournaments. I transferred out of Bay Area, so I know a lot of those skaters. So that's been of particular interest to me.
Yeah.
And good games there, too.
Heck yeah. Mm-hmm. Speaking of Bay Area, I believe I saw Kate Silver in the chat on Twitch. How you doing, Kate?
Hello, Kate. So this is Jam 16 that we're headed into now after that official timeout. Now, we do have two jammers on the track, so maybe there wasn't a jammer penalty at the end of that last jam. It is Cyberpunk wearing the star for Rock City that's out first as lead. Then Diesel wearing the star for Dutchland. Still working against that Rock City defense. Looks like a smaller pack out there for Rock City, but they're doing a great job of hanging on to the jammer. Now everyone is just in a big pile there right at turn one, but looks like Cyberpunk is out for 4 points. Heard some whistles there, and it looks like we will be losing Min Diesel to the penalty box. This will be a power jam for Rock City and Cyberpunk. Four points on the board so far. We'll see if Cyberpunk's going to run this one out for the, or call it, which it will be called. There you go. 8 points, though, before the call off.
Was definitely hearing some hollering from the rock bench there to just call that one off while they still had the power jam. It's hard to hear sometimes when you're out there jamming and you're just trying to not get completely destroyed by blockers. Whole level of awareness required there. It takes some doing. All right, so we are going to start with that power jam for Rock City. Sends out Kiara T to take advantage of that. Min Diesel still in the box for Dutchland. They'll have a few seconds to try to make some hay here. But nice hit to the outside by Dutchland's pivot will send Kiara T back to restart heading into turn one. Pivot is Lorraine Storm in this case, who we've seen take the star a few times for Dutchland, doing some good work out there. Kiara T getting hit again to the outside on turn one, that dangerous outside line. So Kiara T now with lead four. Yeah, go ahead. Did I miss another penalty for the jammer?
Min Diesel back to the box. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Heartbreaker.
Mm-hmm.
So now the full power jam again for Rock City. Kiara T'd through for the first 4 points, coming back around for another scoring pass on the far straightaway. And it looks like Min Diesel is back on the track again. Also contending with the pack heading into turn three, but Kiara T'd through for another 4 points in the meantime. And there's that star pass to Lorraine Storm. Battles her way out to the front and is through. Kiara T'd back around for another scoring pass, getting held up in between turns three and four. Gets told to call it off before Lorraine Storm can score, looks like. Yep. Kept that to a goose egg. No, I'm sorry. 1 point for Dutchland at the end there. Nicely done. Snuck in there at the last minute. So 8-1 on the jam. 116-21 in favor of Rock. We've got about 3.5 minutes left in the first half. Rippy.
So if you guys are watching, from home, the penalty box is right below our camera here. So sometimes if they're... your skater comes in low on that knee pad, you can't see anybody going to the box. So, you have to kind of watch the lower half of your screen here to watch the penalty box. But not speaking of penalties anymore, speaking of the next jam, we have Fifi taking on Steel Wool. Steel Wool hung up behind that defense. Fifi is out of the pack first with lead. Now both jammers out, but it looks like Fifi may, I'm going to imagine, may pass. We don't know. Yes, was able to pass and picks up the points. Oh, I'm sorry, calls it off before the points are put on the board.
Yeah, I decided that one was too close for comfort. Although, Rock with a commanding lead, just very committed, nonetheless, to not letting Dutchland score if they can help it. I mean, that's strategy.
Oh. Sorry.
What? Anything of note?
It was 4 points. They did pick up 4 points. Oh, no, no. Oh. And they just took them down, so I don't know what happened.
It's chaos. It happens. Princess Peach up against Twisted Tweed. Princess Peach getting knocked to the outside. And so is Twisted Tweed. Both jammers recycled back behind the jammer line as the packs start mixing it up in the near straightaway. Both teams once again at full strength as a blocker returns from the box. And nope. And a forearm call on the pivot for Rock. Neither jammer through yet, though. Whoa. Still stuck on this first straightaway. Blocker's doing a nice job of holding up the jammers. Oh, and just taking advantage of some of the confusion and distraction there. Dutchland through for lead. That's Princess Peach. Will come around for a scoring pass as Twisted Tweed still held up at turn one, trying to break free. Packs mixing it up between turns one and two. Twisted Tweed. Why was I saying Tweed? I don't know. I just wanted it to be Tweed, I guess. Through now, able to score as Princess Peach has been trying to make a scoring pass here, is stuck behind all four of Rock's blockers. Gets a little bit of offensive help there from Bangarang Banshee with the pivot helmet on. Not able to get any daylight, but in the meantime, Twisted Teed for Rock City did get through for 4 points. And Princess Peach still fighting, pushing the packs into the far straightaway. That jam will come to its end. And it looks like it'll be even, Steven. 4-4 at the end. Rock City still up with a commanding 128 as I watch the numbers going up. Mm-hmm. Dutchland's 25.
Yeah, I'm not sure we're going to get to launch this next one.
Oh. You're right. Yep. I believe we are at halftime, which I am delighted to see being called intermission here, as though we were at a theater performance.
That's lovely. Yeah. I got to give really a lot of props to Rock City. Though their blockers seem to have a few penalties of rotating bodies in and out of the penalty box, when they had a smaller pack, they were still able to hang on to the jammer, to rotate the defense as they needed to hang on to keep Dutchland from scoring. Really good job for that defensive moves there.
Yeah, absolutely. Rock with a really tight defensive game generally. I think obviously showing that they can play the offensive game, opened up this pretty commanding lead in the first half of the game. Dutchland has their work cut out for them in the second half, and it really just comes down to getting their jammers through for lead as much as possible, because Rock has been able to own the clock and decide who's scoring and when. But you're absolutely right. Great defensive game from Rock's blockers, despite, you know, occasional trouble with penalties and lower numbers on the track at any given time. Dutchland doing some good work. I'm seeing some scrappy offense, in particular from their, on behalf of their jammers, by their pivots, doing a really great job taking the start passes, trying to open up some holes for their jammers. But, you know, despite all that good hard work, it just, you know, it's hard when you're not getting lead. It just makes things real difficult.
It is.
Nura, are you noticing anything?
Yeah, so I have some interesting. Yeah, so for Rock City, Fifi coming in at 53 points. So
Wow.
obviously the top scorer of the game, with four jams, so scoring a 12 points, 4 points, and the 17 and 20 point jam. So she's really doing a lot of work for her team. Then we have Twisted Teed, Cyberpunk, and Kira. Keed all coming in at 16, and then Street Flasher following in with 12 points. So they have about a five jam rotation, and then six star passes on the Dutchland side. So just like you said, you really utilizing that star pass to limit scoring. And they've had about five different jammers coming to the jammer line, but Solar Flexus is actually their highest scoring jammer with 8 points on jam 15. So
Nice.
can
Excellent.
really see the difference there in their jammers.
Thank you. Yeah, that's that puts it into perspective for sure. All right, well, I think Rippy, Nira, should we give the people a little bit of a break? Step away, take care of your
I think
needs.
that's a good idea. Yeah.
I'm going to do the same thing. Looks like we got just about 12 minutes of halftime left, so don't go anywhere. Keep the feed up. Go get some hydration, some caffeine, some chamomile if it's the middle of the night for you in Australia, whatever works for you. And then we'll be right back to walk you through the second half of this game between Dutchland and Rock City at the Birthday Bash, part of WFTDA's Back on Track series. We'll see you in a minute.
Welcome back, everybody. We are here with Dutchland Roller Derby Roller, sorry, out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania, and Rock City Roller Derby out of Rochester, New York. This is a WFTDA Back on Track event, and if you would like to have something similar for one of your games, you can broadcast your games without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming. The remote studio can get your games to a global audience with as little as a smartphone. No matter your location or budget, get streaming with the Remote Studio. Contact broadcast at quadmedia.tv and check out our Broadcasting for Beginners resources at I'm sorry, WFTDA.tv. There we go.
I like the explosion of emojis that just came up on our screen too from the folks in the Twitch chat. It was like a vomit of all the emojis all at once. It's beautiful.
Yes,
But yeah,
it
how cool is it we have this remote broadcast option just to sort of, it's like
Lovely.
equalizing the ability to stream more Derby for people. I think it's fabulous.
Yes.
Thank you for the silly emojis. You're making my day. So yeah, we are rejoining. Just as a reminder, I'm Hammer Abby. I guess we should introduce ourselves again.
I'm Rippy Longstocking.
And I'm Neuralizer.
And we are going to help you get through, enjoy, understand the second half of this game between Dutchland and Rock City at the Birthday Bash in State College, Pennsylvania, where it is currently about 10:51 in the morning, wherever you are in the world, if that's helpful reference. They are playing inside of a giant marshmallow. It's great. So, Rock City made a lot of hay in the first half of this game, 128 to 25 as we head into the second half. Steel Wool jamming for Dutchland, Fifi for Rock City. Fifi through with lead for Rock City, keeping up their streak and a very strong first half. Nira, as you noted, Fifi with the highest scoring jammer of the game by far. So Phoebe around in a scoring pass, hops through on the inside line, gonna get 4 points as Steel Wool still caught up in the pack between turns one and two. We do have a penalty being called on a rock skater, it looks like. Steel Wool through. Phoebe not far behind, checking the bench, seeing what they want her to do. They let Steel Wool through. So Dutchland able to pick up 4 points. Fifi answers it in short order. Pack now on the far straightaway. Steel Wool again around for a scoring pass, contending with two rock blockers as three, sorry, as we push into turn three. Fifi getting knocked to the inside by Dutchland's blockers. resets, finds an outside line open. Last minute hit attempt there. Oh, nice effort from Lorraine Storm. Doesn't hold on to Fifi, though, who gets through for another 4 points. Steel Wool now grinding it out behind a tripod of rock. Able to sort of break things apart, gets the packs moving into the near straightaway. But Fifi going to grab a final 4 points there and call it off. So that will be, it looks like, a 20 points for Rock to 7 points for Dutchland.
Fifi just making some amazing scoring moves out there. I think a vomit, I think a vomit of emojis will be the new collective noun. Thanks. I think that is true.
I'm happy that's my contribution today.
I'm good. Thank you.
All right, as we head into jam number two of the second half of Solar Flex, has taken on Twisted Teed. Everybody just making a big wall there, both teams. Looks like we do have lead that will be assessed to Twisted Teed. Solar Flexus does get bumped into the infield, will now be recycled back, engaging with the defenders again. Meanwhile, Twisted Teed back around, eligible for points. We have some whistles, and that will be, unfortunately, on Solar Flexus. Twisted Teed with control of the track on a power jam. Looking for a way through the defense. Gets through and will... Oh, no! Picks up a cut track. We will switch out. Lead will be rescinded here, and we'll go the full 2 minutes. So each jammer will serve the same number of seconds in the penalty box. Solar Flexus back on the track, engaging with the pack. So Twisted Teed will have a shorter penalty by a few seconds. Everybody collapsing there on Solar Flexus, trying to get through the pack there. Pack is inching towards turn three. Solar Flexus looking for an opening, does find an inside lane, is through the pack. Picks up 4 points there, I believe. Yes. And that jam comes to a close. 4 points on the board for Dutchland. None on the board, it looks like, for Rock City.
The tables did turn in that jam, despite Rock initially giving lead with those double jammer penalties. The currents swung back to Dutchland. You never know how things are going to go. Oh, we're going to have a little time off. Looks like that is getting called by someone off camera. Not sure yet if that was an official or a team.
Yeah, I think they were just settling the score, maybe.
Ah. Important to settle your scores.
It is.
All right, we're back into trivia action. We've got Min Diesel jamming for Dutchland, Street Flasher for Rock City, and it is Street Flasher through with lead for Rock. Min Diesel still stuck behind the pack in the first straightaway, tries to find an outside line, gets hit out. I'm trying to... Slamber alert. I'm trying to shout out the blockers more. It's just tricky that hard to see the numbers from here, but blockers are important and they deserve to have their names called too. Gonna make the effort. Meanwhile, Street Flasher threw the pack for 4 points. Min Diesel still battling it out. Getting into turn two. Street Flasher taking a hit to the inside and gets back in too soon. That's gonna be a track cut call on Street Flasher headed to the box. Min Diesel and Dutchland now with a power jam opportunity, but Min Diesel, I don't believe, has been out of the track yet, so still trying to make this initial pass. Battling against Rock's pivot, pushing out into the turn three, does finally make it. Pulls a penalty on Rock's pivot for sticking with her just a little bit too long there. So Dutchland now in a scoring pass, still in the power jam. in the far straightaway. Comes to a screeching halt behind Rock's blockers, which includes P-Rex and Slamber Alert. Pushing really, really hard, trying to get this pack to move. Min Diesel trying to make some work here. Street Flasher, meanwhile, back on the track, done with the penalty, comes slicing through the pack for another 4 points. Both packs now in turn three. Street Flasher able to find an inside ray of sunshine to move into, gets through for another 4 points. The jam is going to get called off. And it looks like Dutchland ends attempting the middle of attempting a star pass. A little bit too late, unfortunately, to get any points on the board for that jam.
I agree, Hammer. The blocker is doing a great job out there. If you know of a blocker and you would like to shout out in the Twitch chat, please feel free to do so. We want to give love to our blockers as well as our jammers. As we head into jam number four, it's Steel Wool taking on Kiara Teed. And lead is being assessed to Kiara Teed. Rock City, again with lead. Steel Wool gets bumped back, almost to the jammer line. Nice work here, hanging on to Steel Wool, just finding no opening there, getting a little help from a blocker, trying to open up the pack. Meanwhile, Kiara Teed, oh, on the inside lane. Takes a little spill, but is inside the track. We'll get up and earns 4 points for that pass. 8 so far on the board. Pack is slowly inching around the track. We're at the top apex. Not a lot of room there. Great job by both teams sending one blocker back to try to open up the tripod. And I believe we're going to see Kiara Teed out of the pack. Picks up an additional 4-12 so far on the board for Rock City. It appears from my particular view here that there is a star pass attempting to happen for Dutchland because they have really been effective at using that star pass. Yes. They got it right at the end of that jam, but not quite enough to pull off the points. 14 points total for Rock City. 178 to 36.
Yeah, Rippy, it's interesting. I feel like Dutchland was doing a really good job of utilizing the star passes more quickly in the jams as soon as they didn't get lead. And it feels like the two I believe we've had so far in this half have come very late in the jam. So we'll be interested to see what they do with that going forward. And hopefully they'll also find a way to get more lead calls in their favor. But as we go into jam five, it is Rock again with the lead. Not yet sure, apologize, who the jammer is. Solar Flex is jamming for Dutchland. Oh no, we have a stray mask, it looks like, caught in some skates on the track. Yep, that is taken care of though. Love to see that. Opponents helping each other out, working out some technical difficulties. It is Fifi skating, jamming for Rock City. So Fifi, meanwhile, is just, you know, taking care of business, scoring now 8 points. Solar Flexus also through on a scoring pass now, trying to get through the blockers on the near straightaway. Stuck behind P-Rex and Friends as Fifi comes back around, wrangling with Dutchland's blockers. We have some canine cheering on going on here, which I always appreciate. Solar Flexus knocked down to the ground at turn one. Going to try to re-attack the pack here. Fifi through, has 12 points, finds an easy open inside line for another four, bringing it up to 16. Fifi just having a phenomenal game this morning. Still definitely the highest scoring jammer of the game, I think it's safe to say. Pack's now in turn two, getting spread apart a little bit as Fifi comes through, looks like knocked out a little bit and decides to play it safe, comes all the way back around to re-engage with the packs. Dutchling getting a blocker back out of the penalty box, I believe at full strength. As that jam comes to an end, because Fifi decides, I'll match my other highest scoring jam, 20 points. To zero, eat my words. 4 points for Dutchland at the end there. It's great to see. So 198 Rock City to 41 for Dutchland. Just over 18 minutes left in the half, second half.
I agree. I think that's Nanasonic on the chat. We're going to need to see that dog.
Show us the dog. Maybe at the end of the game, have a dog cameo.
So headed into jam number six here, we do have Cyberpunk out of the pack first for Rock City. Min Diesel's wearing the star for Dutchland. Will be tapped out of bounds, has to be recycled back. The entire pack just sitting here in the first straightaway. Cyberpunk through the pack picks up four, and that brings Rock City over the 200 point mark. Min Diesel again has the star in hand. So I'm wondering, Hammer, if maybe Rock City is now aware of the fact that Dutchland will be passing that star if they don't get out of the pack initially, making it a little bit more difficult for that star pass to happen. This ended up being a star stash, however, and so Rock City puts eight on the board for that round and keeps Dutchland scoreless.
Yeah, well noted, Rippy. I think you may be right. Rock's just kind of on to Dutchland's game. The star stash can be very effective as well. I mean, if you just sort of confuse them about who has the star and who's going to get the star, that may be enough to pop your jammer free without actually ever having to pass off the helmet cover. Pack starting well spread out for this start of this jam. Steel Wool for Dutchland, again, in the black. Twisted Teed for Rock City in the white. My apologies, Twisted Teed. I know I called you Twisted Tweed a couple of times in the first half. That was my bad. And you make up for it by getting lead. Steel Wool hot on the heels of Rock Jammer through this pack, though. So that's going to be a quick one. Rock City doesn't like it, calls it off. So no points for anyone on that jam.
It's Shanksy in the chat. What's up, Shanksy? That's a quality human being right there. We are ticking down to about 15 and a half minutes left in the second half here, our first game today. On the jammer line, we have Solar Flexus taking on Street Flasher. Street Flasher through the pack, but ends up picking up a penalty. So no leads. Lead is still available for Dutchland if Solar Flexus can get out of the pack. Everybody descending on that defense, trying to help get the jammer through. Looks like we have some passive defense here. Some of our pack hanging back to try to stretch out the pack. Solar Flexus pushing against the top, but is going to get a little help there from the pivot. Trying to get around the outside. Now goes to the inside, back and forth across the track. Pack is getting spread out. Solar Flexus at the top. And I believe we're going to see no lead has been assessed. So it must have been a no pass, no penalty situation. So there will be no lead here. Some of that action happened off the screen, but we know that Solar Flexus is eligible for points. Street Flasher, not sure if the penalty was called after exiting the pack, so we'll have to look at the jam ref here to see if Street Flasher is eligible for points as well. Everybody just fighting through. No, that was the initial pass. So that penalty came before the exiting of the pack. And it looks like we're having several people coming in and out of the box here. Oh, just a little pile up. And solar plexus coming out of the penalty box there, you see at the bottom of the screen. Street Flasher with 4 points so far. I do believe Solar Flexus might have been through the pack the initial time, so I want to look and see if what kinds of score will be put on the board here. I cannot see the Jam Ref's hands. 4 points total there for Dutchland. 4-4 run. We're at 13 minutes and 30 seconds left in the second half.
Whew. That was one of those jams that you just kind of like, you gotta take a breath afterwards, reset yourself a little bit. Things got a little hairy for both teams. We had penalties, a go-go. No lead called. That's always disheartening, but you know, you can still score points. You just gotta skate the whole 2 minute jam. What it is. I want to shout out Dutchland. I just realized I'm pretty sure they've hosted a tournament in the past that my team has had the chance to go and play. I'm completely blanking on what it was, but they were wonderful hosts. So I want to shout out Dutchland for being very hospitable, good folks. It may well have been a playoff. See, everything before the pandemic is just like
right. It's a blur.
I don't remember details anymore. But want to shout it out for that. So. It is an interesting position to be in. I have been on the team that is down by a lot, that is having a hard time getting those lead calls that help you manage the clock, that help you, you know, control who's scoring. And it becomes a mental game, just as much as the physical game. Mm-hmm. Physical game is always there, whether you like it or not. But the mental game is so important at that point. What can we still get out of this? What can we do as a team to, you know, stay positive, keep working on what we want to work on? This game is very, it's just not going to go Dutchland's way in the end. We're at 13 minutes left in this game. There's too big of a score differential to make up in that time, but we'll see what Dutchland can do. They're still doing a lot of good work on the track. Some really great defensive work, working on those star passes, all good things. Rock City just really, really able to confidently own. It's that new cut track rule. You can get away with that. Rock City doing great work today. Kiara T jamming for Rock. And that's who we were sort of like, almost came back in, that would have been a cut, but with the new rules, you can kind of say, oops, my bad, and jump back out again and be fine. Packs getting real spread out between turns one and two, and Kiara T taking advantage to get lead for Rock. Steel Wool jamming for Dutchland gets hit out and is going to get recycled way back from almost the far straightaway, now back to turn one by Miranda Hindle. Kiara teed back around on a scoring pass. Both packs coming into turn two. Steel Wool trying to push the pack through. I think has the star cover in her hand. Yep, looking for the pivot. So right now it's just a star stash. Looking for the handoff there. It is hard to see across the track from here. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, Kiara teed picking up 4 points for Rock City. Packs now on the far straightaway. Given the fact that Rock's blockers are all now trying to stop the pivot, I would assume the pivot has the star cover in her hand. And that looks like it's going to be acid rain. So while that's all happening, though, in the far straightaway, Kiara T battles her way through for another 4 points for Rock. Pack's being pushed into turn three. Kiara T back around. Acid rain not yet out. Little tiny hop on the inside line for Kiara gets her through, and she's going to call it off before, unfortunately, Acid Rain unable to break free of that pack, and we have an official timeout being called. So that was a 12-point jam for Rock City. Dutchland 0. Rock with a nice 2-2-2 across the board. Dutchland at 45. As we get a little time to take a little breather. What's going on, Rippy?
So did you see that Dutchland hosted the Continental Cup? One of the Continental Cups before, this was a couple of years before the pandemic. Eastbound Throwdown. Is that the one you were thinking about?
That may well have been it. Yes, because I think we both played at that, and I might have announced at it too. Again, it all
right
blurs together, but that sounds right.
It kind of
that sounds like.
But yeah, that was back when the Continental Cup was a thing. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, and also the question that is, we're on Eastern time here for this particular tournament. So we're right at 11, almost quarter after 11, almost there.
Yeah.
And that was a very long rolling whistle. An exceptionally long rolling whistle.
Put some stank on it.
I know, it did. And that is the official whistle to start this next jam. We are at jam 10, right at about 11 minutes left in the second half. Min Diesel wearing the star for Dutchland, but it's Fifi out for Rock City as lead. Fifi, again, one of the highest scorers we have here, or the highest scorer, rather, for this particular game. Fifi three for four. And that was a very quick turnaround, just 4 points picked up and called off the jam.
Yeah, it looked like Dutchland's jammer got through and pretty quick there right after Fifi, so they went ahead and called that one short. Yeah. Yeah, I want to shout out again, anybody who's tuning in now or after the fact to this, who's coming in from a different, entirely different time zone. These back-to-track events are happening across the globe, so definitely tune in for ones that are at a more palatable time for you as well, but you can also find them after the fact on the WFTDA YouTube channel. Heading into Jam 11, Solar Flexus jamming for Dutchland, Cyberpunk for Rock City. Cyberpunk out front, pushes the pack apart at turn one, is through for lead. Solar Flexus now with a quick star pass to the pivot. For Dutchland. Pivot now still stuck in the pack, though. Takes a minute to play some quick defense and is now trying to find her way around. Oh, big pile up on turn two. And yep, that was a low block, as someone in the crowd shouted. Being assessed to a Dutchland blocker. Cyberpunk through for four comes around for another scoring pass. Both packs tangled up in turn two now. Acid Rain. The pivot, now with the star in her hand, officially becomes, well, sort of officially becomes the jammer. Can't, not through the pack yet, though. Rocks blockers still just doing an excellent job in that tripod formation. A little bit of offense there coming in. Big hits being laid by Dutchland, trying to break that apart so Acid Rain can get through. Now on the far straightaway. Still no joy, though, as Cyberpunk comes around, scores more points for Rock City. Gets the go-ahead from the bench there to keep going. Boy, Cyberpunk is a throwback name for me. Pretty sure I used to play that RPG in the 90s. And meanwhile, three for another 4 points, 16 for Cyberpunk. On the jam, Dutchland's Acid Rain still dealing with the blockers on the far straightaway. Has the star in her head now. Whew, that was a fight. That was a hard fight. Didn't quite make it through. Black City was 16 to Dutchland 0 on that one. Sometimes you eat the bear, sometimes the bear eats you.
Yeah.
Once Ben have been there as a jammer, nothing but sympathy.
As Hammer talked about earlier, our global events for the Back on Track series include games in the U.S., games in the United Kingdom, Austria, New Zealand, Spain, Sweden, Chile, Mexico, and Argentina, and more games are being added every single day. So you do need to check out the WFTDA Back on Track events websites, wftda.org, Back on Track, to see what all is happening there with that schedule. There are certainly some times that will be happy with your sleep schedule.
And some people don't care. They will watch roller derby anytime, anywhere. And I love this for you.
Yes. And I think Derby After Midnight does sound like a fun party, but also a really great band name.
I was thinking more like, you know, they used to do USA Up All Night and play the really awesome, weird horror movies and stuff. So I feel like we should have a derby after midnight where the announcers get to like get extra salty.
Yeah.
Or just weird, weird, a little weird. So we are at a team timeout. Not entirely sure which team called it, if anybody
Think
caught
it's
that.
Dutchland.
Okay.
I think that's
I think
right.
we're just about to finish that though, so we'll get back to the action.
And okay, that was the starting whistle. It sounded like a timeout whistle, but that was the starting whistle. We have Steel Wool wearing the star for Dutchland, Twisted Teed wearing the star for Rock City, and it's Twisted Teed out of the pack first for Rock City. Rock City again, just dominating on the leads for this particular game. Steel Wool looks for an inside lane, is denied. I think I mentioned before, Rock City's defense doing a great job out there, hanging on to the jammer. Both jammers are now out of the pack. Twisted Teed has 4 points on the board, is behind Steel Wool, and we'll call it right as Steel Wool heads into the pack. So we're under 7 minutes for the second half of this game, 246 to 45 in favor of Rock City.
I will say I'm noticing more fast jams, as in short jams, happening. So Dutchland making some good progress here in terms of being able to put on pressure more quickly, either get their jammers out more quickly or do the star pass more quickly, forcing Rock to call off jams a little bit quicker than they have been. So keeping them a little bit lower scoring. So a nice little change, a little bit of momentum change there. Every little bit is good. Min Diesel, nope. Lies. Someone else jamming for Dutchland. We'll find out in a second. Street Flasher. No, it is Min Diesel. Street Flasher jamming for Rock City. You know, it is what it is.
Yes.
We're all having a good time this morning. And unfortunately, Street Flasher headed to the box. Penalty for Rock City's jammer. So power jam opportunity for Dutchland and Min Diesel, who is sprung free in the far straightaway, has a scoring opportunity
Hooray!
now. And the crowd goes wild. Min Diesel around in the first scoring pass, still in the far straightaway, getting the two blockers from Rock spread out a little bit in the front. A little passive defense in the back there from Dutchland's skaters. So Min Diesel just doing the good old-fashioned sled push here, trying to get Rock's blockers to break the pack. No joy just yet. Street Flasher back on the track, so that power jam does come to an end, and Street Flasher finds an inside line open, is through but is not lead. Dutchland does have that. They're gonna call it off. So always an interesting choice, and I don't say this judgmentally. If you're down that much, you want to like spend some time just getting some points on the board. Do you want to allow the other team to get points as well, though? Eh. I could see it going either way. Dutchland decides they don't want Rock to get any more points, so they get 3 to Rock's 0 on that jam.
Great job by Dutchland on that round. Picking up lead, controlling the track. And I see that Kate Silver is bringing up the quiet storm. How dare you bring up something that tells our age? How dare you? So we are now into Jam 14. Looks like we have Solar Flexus taking on Kiara Teed. The pack just in a big bunch up right here. Oh, it looks like Kiara found that opening. Kiara Teed out of the pack. Picks up lead for Rock City. Yeah, we see that Solar Flexus taking off the cap, looking for the pivot, but does get bumped out of bounds. So again, I think Rock City is aware that Dutchland likes that star pass. So they're going to get interfere as much as possible, but there it goes, handoff. So Looks like we do have a penalty being assessed for KRT. Is that a recycle or a penalty? Okay, I just wanted to check and make sure. She was heading to the penalty box, so this will be a power jam. The lead will be rescinded. So the star pass now is in officially Princess Peach's hand. On the inside lane, Princess Peach picks up, or I'm sorry, goes through the initial. Needs to get that cap on before arriving to the pack. Everybody's setting up for offense on this power jam. But Rock City again collapsing on the jammer. And there is the end of that penalty. KRT back on the track, makes a move on the pack, picks up points on that pass. That jam ticks to a close. I believe it will settle out at 4-0. I think, there are three for Dutchland on that. So it looks like 4-3 on that run.
And a timeout being called on the track by the officials.
Yeah.
Take a little break here. Rock City sitting at 250 to Dutchland's 51. We are at just about 2 minutes left in this game, the first game of this birthday bash weekend in State College, Pennsylvania, hosted by State College Roller Derby. State College Area Roller Derby, because it's SCAR.
SCAR.
A great acronym. More games coming up, pretty much back-to-back today and tomorrow. Let me bring up the full roster of teams that are playing this weekend. I can never remember it off the top of my head. Real quick for you. So State College playing Gem City from Dayton, Ohio, Queen City from Buffalo, New York, Philly Roller Derby, obviously from Philly, Steel City from Pittsburgh, Dutchland, Ithaca, and Rock. Great lineup of teams this weekend. All right, we're into Jam 15, a real quick lead with a nice little hop, skip and a jump from Slamber Alert, who I believe this would be Slamber Alert's first time jamming for Rock City. Nura, is that right?
That's correct, yep. We haven't seen her yet.
She's been out there blocking for sure. Steel Wool jamming for Dutchland, still stuck behind the pack heading into turn one, where Slamber Alert battles her way through for another 4 points, having herself a nice first jam of the game. Steel Wool is through now on the initial pass, can start scoring, but Slamber Alert's gonna pick up 4 points in the meantime. Pack's hanging out in turn one. I'm hearing the bench yell to call it off, which she does. A very respectable 12 points for Slamber Alert's first jam of the game, 4 points matched by Dutchland. We got about a minute left in this game, so this may well be the last jam of the game.
If you want to check out the SCAR Derby birthday celebration website, you can go to scarderby.com/birthday bash, and you can see the full lineup there that Hammer just read to you. We are in Jam 16, just a little bit of time left on the game clock, and it is Min Diesel that picks up lead for Dutchland. Cyberpunk wearing the star for Rock City. Everybody piled up here at turn one. It looks like Cyberpunk out of the pack as well. See what Dutchland decides to do with this control of the track. They will call it. They did put 4 points on the board, and I think that will conclude.
That's all she
that
wrote.
Was the last jam. You were correct.
Hey! I mean, you never know. They can stop it really quick and then call a timeout. You can sometimes squeeze in that last jam if you feel so inclined. But yep, we have hit the end of this first game. Rock City with the win, 262 to Dutchland's 59. Dutchland putting in some nice second half Started the second half a little bit slow, but definitely picked up some momentum with their star passes, with getting their jammers out a little bit more quickly, keeping those jams shorter. And Nira, I'd be curious, did you happen to pick up this total score in the first half versus the second half? I feel like Dutchman scored more points, quite a few more points in the second half.
They did. Unfortunately, I don't have those numbers right on me, but I will say that it was interesting that in the beginning they were actually not calling the jams off with Fifi. The first couple of jams, they let the whole jam roll, and she scored 20 points on two consecutive jams. So I thought that was a pretty interesting statistic there. And then just with, it's a story of Rock City. They just, you know, almost all of their jams, except for three, were all double-digit jams. And they had five box trips for their jammers to two for Dutchland. So that just really tells a story of some really good defense and also just separating those pivots from their jammers.
Yeah,
so that's kind of the summary of that game for them. They really adjusted to Dutchland's star pass strategy.
Everybody looks very happy, though. Always nice to see at the end of the game.
I love seeing the hand slaps. This is my favorite.
Yep.
Everybody did a really great job. Like to shout out to the defense as well. I mean, those blockers were really, really hanging on to the jammers, really making it. Making that the leg days pay off at the gym.
Never skip leg day.
Never.
Paying for leg day right now. I'm actually really happy to be sitting down, is all I'll say. Worth it. I will shout out real quick, just if you're with us on the Twitch screen stream, there is another game coming up pretty much immediately after this. It'll start at 12 noon Eastern United States time. It's going to be Steel City taking on Queen City. Rippy, I think you're sticking around for that one, so you'll be a familiar face carrying through.
Yeah. I will be here as well.
Oh, great. Great. Both of you.
Yay.
Excellent. Yeah. I will be taken off, but it has been an absolute pleasure to watch and call this game with you both. I will be back tomorrow afternoon for the very final game of the tournament.
Oh,
nice.
Yeah. My home teams are having our draft party this afternoon. So I got to go hang out. We have substantially changed how we do things here in Madison, and we're welcoming a whole lot of great new people, and I'm very excited about it. So
excellent. Excellent.
Yeah.
But shout see out you guys to on the track sometime soon.
Yeah, hopefully. I think our travel team is doing some travel. We're trying to host some stuff here in Madison as everybody gets back on track. We're, like so many leagues, we're trying to find a new permanent practice space because we're losing our traditional one. That's just the story of roller derby these days, though, I feel like. So solidarity to everybody who's trying to find places to play roller derby in this terrible real estate market.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Although Nira, you guys down in Texas, it's like way easier to play outside during the winter, I think, than it is here in Wisconsin.
Yeah, but they don't have any shade. And when I first got down here in August, it was 105. And so that was not so nice.
Yeah. Not ideal. Not ideal. All right. Well, I think we will, wrap things up here for folks. Keep tuning in on Twitch. Tell your friends. Remember that you can catch the recordings of these after the fact. WFTDA.com for all of your roller derby needs. I am Hammer Abby.
I'm Rippy Longstocking.
I'm Neuralizer.
We'll see you again shortly. Thank you so much.